हाँ जी स्टूडेंट्स, गुड इवनिंग, गुड मॉर्निंग और गुड नाइट अकॉर्डिंग टू द टाइम, जिस भी टाइम तुसी इस वीडियो नू देखोगे। सो इन टूडेज सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अप्रोक्सीमेटली 45 क्वेश्चंस दैट आर रिलेटेड टू कनकेव मिरर, कन्वेक्स मिरर और यू कैन से प्लेन मिरर। सो बेसिकली यू कैन कंक्लूड दैट इन टूडेज सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस approximately all the questions which are on the basis of reflection of light. So this video is according to the term 1 syllabus, and here we are going to discuss all the important multiple choice questions that we have sent in the group. So if you have not received this PDF, then you can drop the message to us. Our phone number will be provided in the description box. So now we are starting the session. So 120 question booklet, this is the PDF, and from this PDF we are going to discuss the all questions. So this is my contact number, you can contact on this number whenever any type of query is there, any type of doubt is there, you can contact on this given number. So now we are going to start the session, and the first question which is displaying on your screen is focal length of the plane mirror is. So students, basically what do you mean by focal length? That thing we have already discussed in the class. So now he is asking focal length of the plane mirror. So I will try to draw all the diagrams that will clear your all doubts. So now I am going to draw the diagram. You can see here the question is regarding the focal length of plane mirror. So students, let's suppose this white color. Okay, this is the plane mirror here. So plane mirror means straight line whose one side is polished. So let's suppose it's this side is polished. So now whenever a ray of light will incident on it, okay, so focus means where the lines ray of lights are meeting after the reflection. So let's suppose one ray of light incident on this mirror. So let's draw that line. Wait. Okay, so this green color line is incidenting on this plane mirror in this way. Wait. In this way it will incident on it. In this way, let's suppose three rays are incident. They are hitting the surface in this way. So these rays are incident rays. These are the three rays which incident on the plane mirror. Now what will happen? Reflection will take place. So how reflection will take place? To find the direction of reflected rays, we have to draw the normal here. So with this purple color, I am going to indicate the normal. Normal is always perpendicular to the surface, so this will be the normal. Now you can say incident angle is 0 degree. Again, here normal, incident angle 0 degree. Again, here normal, incident angle is 0 degree. So these rays will reflect in the same direction. So these three rays will reflect in same direction, opposite way. In this way, when they incident at 0 degree, they will be also reflected at 0 degree. So now these three rays, they will retrace their path. These three rays will retrace their path now. That means they are not meeting at any point. Now you can see here. You can see here that these three rays after reflection, these three rays after reflection meeting are not meeting at any point. Wait for 1 minute, marker is not working. Wait for 1 minute, please. Okay, let's see it again. It's again not working. Wait. Wait for 1 minute, it's again not working. So here you can see द रिफ्लेक्टेड रेज आर नॉट मीटिंग एट पॉइंट. नाउ आई थिंक मार्कर इज वर्किंग. लेट्स सी. यस, नाउ दिस इज वर्किंग. सो हेयर यू कैन सी दीज थ्री रेज आर रिट्रेसिंग देयर पाथ. थ्री रेज आर रिट्रेसिंग देयर इंसिडेंट पाथ. सो दैट मीन्स दे विल नॉट मीट एट अ पॉइंट. सो इफ द रेज आर नॉट एट मीटिंग एट अ पॉइंट, दैट मीन्स फोकल लेंथ विल बी एट, दे आर नॉट मीटिंग एट अ पॉइंट, सो दैट मीन्स फोकल लेंथ विल बी इक्वल टू इनफाइनाइट. वी डोंट नो द डिस्टेंस वेयर द लाइन्स आर मीटिंग. सो दैट्स वाई द आंसर फॉर द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, दैट इज द फोकल लेंथ ऑफ प्लेन मिरर, दैट आंसर विल बी इन्फिनिटी. वी डोंट नो द डिस्टेंस एट विच द लाइन्स विल बी मीटिंग. सो हेयर यू कैन सी द डायग्राम. दिस विल बी द डायग्राम दैट विल हेल्प यू टू अंडरस्टैंड द क्वेश्चन एंड द आंसर फॉर द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. यस स्टूडेंट्स, इफ यू फाइंड दिस वीडियो यूजफुल, देन यू हैव टू शेयर दिस वीडियो विद यूर फ्रेंड्स हु आर स्टडिंग इन द ग्रेड 10th. सो फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन यूर आंसर विल बी एट इन्फिनिटी. सो फोकल लेंथ ऑफ द प्लेन मिरर विल बी एट इन्फिनिटी. सो ऑप्शन नंबर सी विल बी द राइट आंसर फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. आई होप दिस वीडियो विल बी वेरी यूजफुल फॉर ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स हु आर स्टडिंग इन द ग्रेड 10th. फॉर ऑल द CBSE स्टूडेंट्स दिस वीडियो विल बी वेरी यूजफुल. सो आंसर फॉर द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन विल बी एट इन्फिनिटी. वी कैनॉट फाइंड एट विच पॉइंट द रेज आर मीटिंग, सो दैट्स वाई इट्स आंसर विल बी एट इन्फिनिटी. लेट्स मूव टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज इमेज फॉर्म्ड बाय द प्लेन मिरर. सो हेयर यू कैन सी, लेट्स सपोज अ पर्सन इज स्टैंडिंग हेयर. ओके, लेट्स सपोज सिंपल वे, दीज रेज आर नॉट मीटिंग एट अ पॉइंट, दिस रे इज नॉट मीटिंग एट अ पॉइंट, दिस रे इज नॉट मीटिंग एट अ पॉइंट, दीज रिफ्लेक्टेड रेज आर नॉट मीटिंग एट अ पॉइंट. दैट मीन्स विच टाइप ऑफ इमेज इट विल फॉर्म. इट विल ऑलवेज, इफ द रिफ्लेक्टेड रेज आर नॉट मीटिंग एट अ पॉइंट, ऑटोमेटिकली देन वी हैव टू एक्सटेंड दैम बैकवर्ड. सो दैट मीन्स विच टाइप ऑफ इमेज प्लेन मिरर विल फॉर्म. प्लेन मिरर विल फॉर्म वर्चुअल इमेज. आई होप दिस थिंग विल बी वेरी क्लियर. We have already discussed in the class then that if the reflected rays are not meeting at a point, automatically, if the reflected rays are not meeting at a point automatically, then the image formed by the plane mirror will be, or any mirror will be, virtual. So here the answer for image formed by plane mirror is, so answer for this question will be option number C. Option B will be the right answer, that is image formed by plane mirror will be virtual image. So I hope this question is also clear. So image formed by the plane mirror is, note down the answer keys. We will discuss, try to discuss almost 20 questions in this session, and in the next session we will also try to discuss the next questions. So at least 100 likes are required for this video. 100 share and like you have to do. 100 comments you can have to do. Then we will prepare the next video. So image formed by plane mirror. I hope this question will be clear to all the students. Answer for this question will be virtual image that is not formed by automatically meeting the reflected rays. So when reflected rays are not automatically meeting, in that case the virtual image is formed. So option number B will be the right answer for second question. Let's move to the third question. So image formed by plane mirror. Now plane mirror is that mirror which you have to use in the your homes. Basically you will use your in your homes. So basically you will see, when you will see your image in the plane mirror, let's suppose this is plane mirror, and if you see your image from here, you are standing here like this one. If this person is standing here in this way, then his head will be at the same position. Let's suppose his image now we are going to draw. So this is the polished side, this is the polished side of the mirror, that is plane mirror. So now what will happen, His image will be formed like this one. This is his head will remain at top and legs will be at bottom as shown in the actual. So that means this is erect image. If the top will remain at top and the bottom will remain at bottom, that means this is what type of image? This is erect image. So image formed by the plane mirror, remember the key points. Image formed by a plane mirror is, image formed by the plane mirror is virtual, erect and of the same size. Please note down all the key points. Image formed by the plane mirror is erect, virtual and have the same size. Okay, so now we are moving to the question number 4. The question number 4 is, radius of the curvature is plus 40 centimeter. So radius of the curvature is plus 40 centimeter. Which type of mirror it is? So here this is another important question. Radius of the curvature is given to you. Now whose radius of curvature is positive? Let's see. Which mirror has positive radius of curvature? I hope you have seen this mirror. Now let's suppose object is lying here. Wait for 1 second, students. Let's suppose object is lying here. So when object will be lying here, incident ray will be along this direction. Its outer surface will be reflecting one and this surface will be polished. So this surface is coated one. This surface is coated or this surface is polished surface. So now students, what will happen? If we measure, basically we have to measure the all distances from pole. This is the pole of this mirror and this is the focal length, sorry, this is focus and this is the center of curvature. So basically when we have to measure the distance from pole, we will measure the distance in this direction, pole to C. So now we are moving towards the right direction, pole to C. So this incident ray is also along the left to right direction. So that means in this case, if it is the radius, then it will be positive. So which mirror has positive center of curvature or positive focal length? Students, if we measure the focal length here also, the focal length of which type of mirror? Convex mirror. So this is which type of mirror? Here this will be the focal length. So focal length will be also positive. So that means which mirror has positive focal length and positive center of curvature? Students, please note down. Which mirror has positive focal length and positive center of curvature or positive radius of curvature? Like here you will see. Here in the fourth question, the question is saying radius of curvature is plus 40 centimeter. So which type of mirror it is? So I hope it will be clear that now which type of mirror it will be. It will be convex mirror because its radius of curvature will be positive. We have to take the radius from here. This is pole and we have to move towards the center of curvature. So it will be center of curvature. It will be pole. So whenever we will measure the distance from left to right direction, this is the polished surface. So whenever we will measure the distance along the incident ray, we have to take the value positive. So the mirror whose radius of curvature is positive, and if positive is given or some value is given like 40 centimeter here given, so in that case, which type of mirror it will be? It will be the, its name will be convex mirror. So its answer will be convex mirror, or you can say its answer will be diverging mirror. Convex mirror is also called diverging mirror. So its answer can be diverging mirror also. So we have discussed the four questions in this video till now. If you find that this video is useful to you, then you can like this video, you can share this video, and you can subscribe to our channel so that you will get the regular updates whenever we will upload the next video. So four questions we have discussed here. Now we are going to move to the next question. So the next question which will be displaying on the screen is question number 5. So question number 5, we have already discussed this type of property. Which focal length of a spherical mirror is plus 10 cm? Which type of mirror it is? So we have already discussed this type of mirror. We have just discussed right now that focal length and center of curvature of which mirror is positive? Convex mirror. So instead of convex mirror, you can find the answer by the another option also, that can be diverging mirror. So diverging mirror is which one? That is convex mirror. So question number 5, I think it is very much clear to all the students. Now next question is question number 6. Focal length of the spherical mirror is minus 20 cm. Which type of mirror it is? So students, now focal length is negative and radius of curvature is also negative in question number 7. Okay, so question number 6 and 7. Now we are going to discuss the question number 6. So now you can note down the concave mirror also, because till now we have not discussed the concave mirror. So this is the basically converging mirror. You can name it converging or concave mirror. So this side will be the polished side. This side will be the polished side. I will tell you why its focal length and its radius of curvature will be negative. So if this side is polished side, okay, let's suppose let's take blue color. So let's suppose three rays are coming from a point. Okay, this ray is incidenting at a point. This ray is also incidenting at a point, and these all rays will pass through this focus. So this ray, let's suppose another ray is coming on this side, it will be reflected along the same path. So all rays are basically meeting at a point. So they are meeting at this point. Okay, wait. All the rays are meeting at this point, and this point is called focus. This is the center of curvature, and this point is basically pole. So now what we have to do, we have to measure the distance from pole to center focus, because all the distances we have to measure them from pole. So pole to focus. So this is against the incident ray. Incident ray is what? Incident ray is along left to right direction. But now we are measuring the distance from right to left direction, pole to focus. So that means its focal length will be, now we have to take the sign conventions, and the answer will be negative. Either that is focal length, or that will be radius of curvature. Radius of curvature will be also negative, and the focal length of this mirror will be also negative. Please note that this type of mirror is called, firstly, concave mirror is the name of this mirror. Concave mirror, you can note its another name. Yes, students, please note its another name is converging mirror, because rays are meeting at a point after reflection. So this is which type of mirror? This is the converging mirror. Please note down. Now we have to move to the question. Now the question is asking, focal length of a spherical mirror is minus 20. So what we have discussed, that either he will give you focal length negative, or the examiner will give you radius of curvature negative. So either he will provide the focal length negative or radius of curvature negative. In both the cases, your answer will be concave mirror. So its answer will be concave mirror, the mirror whose focal length is negative. So concave mirror will be the right answer for question number 6. And for question number 7 also, radius of curvature of a mirror is minus 40 centimeter. So in this case also, the type of mirror about which the examiner is asking or the author is asking, the radius of curvature in this case is minus 40. That means it will be also same mirror that we have discussed in the question number 6. So this will be concave mirror. In place of concave mirror, you can find the answer as converging mirror also. So students, yahan pe jo answer hai, that can be converging mirror also instead of concave mirror. So 7 questions we have discussed during this 20 minutes duration. In the next 20 minutes, we are going to discuss all the questions quickly, and about 20 questions we will discuss today. So next is the radius of curvature of the mirror is plus 40 centimeter. Its focal length will be. So students, there is a relation between focal length and radius of curvature. Focal length is basically equal to half of radius of curvature. So we will discuss the diagram also. So focal length will be equal to R by basically R divided by 2. So in this type of diagram, you can see this will be center of curvature and this will be focal length. So focal length is basically half of the radius of curvature. So this is the second value, this is the value 2. So students, what I am saying that radius of curvature, half of radius of curvature will be equal to focal length. So in this question, the radius of curvature is 40. So 40 by 2, your answer will be 20 centimeter. And if radius of curvature is positive, then obviously focal length will be also positive. So it will be plus 20. So answer will be plus 20 centimeter. For the question number 8, your answer will be option number C. So I hope this question is also clear to all the students. Students, one more thing is that if you find this video useful, then share this video with all of your friends. Basically what we will do, we will approximately make 5 parts for first term syllabus. Basically we will make 5 videos on the first term syllabus, in which we will approximately cover 120 or more than 120 questions. So approximately every part will contain 20 to 30 questions. In this today's video, we are going to discuss 20 questions. 8 questions we have discussed already. So now we are moving to the question number 9. So question number 9 is displaying on the screen, and it is saying radius of curvature of a plane of a mirror is plus 80 centimeter. Its focal length will be. So students, plus 80 means, okay, plus 80 centimeter focal length. Okay, radius of curvature is given. Its focal length we have to find. So focal length is half of radius of curvature. So its answer will be plus 40 centimeter. Half of 80. So half of 80 will be, half of 80, that will be equal to 40 centimeter. So 40 centimeter will be the right answer for this question number 9. Let's move to the next question. If any doubt is there up to question number 9, then you can drop that doubt in the comment box. Let's move to question number 10. Focal length of the plane mirror is given, and we know focal length is half of radius of curvature. So R by 2 will be equal to focal length. So if focal length is given to you, you have to twice the radius. So you have to twice that focal length to find the radius. So here radius of curvature you have to find. focal length that you already know that is equal to 20. So radius of curvature will be 20 into 2, that will be 40. So R will be equal to 20 into 2, 40 centimeter. And if focal length is positive, then obviously radius of curvature will be also positive. So here your answer will be plus 40 centimeter. For the question number 10, your right answer will be option number A. So these are the questions that similar type of questions you can expect in the examination. So now we are going to the next question, that is question number 11. Concave mirror gives real, inverted and same size image if the object is placed. So students, this question is asked from the images, the cases of images produced by concave mirror. So in case of concave mirror, okay, this is concave mirror na, okay, wait. So in case of concave mirror, when the object is placed at 2C, sorry, when the object is placed at C, so this is the center of curvature. Wait, we will discuss the question. So this is what? This is the center of curvature and this is basically focus. So when the object is placed here, let's discuss this case also. So when the object is placed here, then one ray will incident from here and it will pass through focus in this way. And one ray will incident on this pole and it will be reflected in this way. So basically what will happen? So basically what will happen, students, during this case, the same size image will be formed just below the object, same size image is formed. So this type of image is real because rays are meeting at a point after reflection. So this is real image, inverted image and same size image. So basically object is placed where? Object is placed at center of curvature, or center of curvature is also equal to 2f. So 2f is what? Twice of focal length. So radius of curvature is equal to twice of focal length. So this can be the answer also, 2f. So let's see what are the options. Okay, so here the options are not related to 2f. So 2f is not required here. So now I am going to erase the content. You can note down the figure if required. Yes, students, you can note down the figure if this figure is required. The size of object will be same as size of image. So if object is having the height 10 cm, then image will be having the same height 10 cm. So same size means height of object will be equal to height of image. So this is the case when object is placed at C. So for this question number 11, your right answer will be at C. When the object is placed at center of curvature, then the concave mirror gives real, inverted and same size image. So if you have seen the image formation by different mirrors, then obviously you have seen this type of case also, in which case this type and this type of characteristics are formed by the image. So question number 11 clear, option number C will be the right answer for this question number 11. Now we are moving to the question number 12. A concave mirror gives a virtual erect and enlarged image. So this is the another case that we are going to discuss. A concave mirror gives a virtual erect and enlarged image. So this is the case when object is placed between pole and focus. Let's discuss its ray diagram firstly. So this is the concave mirror now. When the object is placed between pole and focus, then one ray will incident here and it will pass through focus Then another ray will incident on at the pole and it will be reflected in this way. So these two rays are basically not meeting at a point. So in this case we have to extend them backward. So basically we have to extend them backward in the backward direction. So the image is formed at a point. Obviously this type of image that we will make after extending the rays manually, the rays are not meeting at a point automatically. So this type of image is basically virtual image. So this is enlarged image and virtual image and erect image. So this side of the mirror is obviously polished. So this side is obviously polished, that you know, in case of concave mirror. So I am also displaying the diagrams trying to explain all the questions step by step so that all the doubts will be clear to you. So this is which type of image, let's discuss the question now. The question is saying virtual, erect and enlarge. So here you can see all the properties are now matching. Okay, here you can see this image is obviously virtual. Erect means which will be in the upper direction, which will be in the upper direction, which will be vertically upward. So this is virtual image, erect image and enlarge image. So all the three conditions are matching, but the now you have to find the position of objective. So position is, this is pole, this is, this point is pole, and this is what, this is focus. So when the object is placed, when the object is placed between pole and focus, then the image formed in case of concave mirror will be virtual, erect and enlarge. So I hope this is the real actual diagram that you have to understand basically in this case, and the right answer for question number 12 will be when the object is placed between pole and focus. So option number B will be the right answer for question number 12. So question number 12, B option will be the right answer. Let's move to the question number 13 now. The question is saying the object is placed at 10 cm in front of concave mirror produces erect image. The radius of curvature of the mirror will be. So students, this is the another question that you have to understand. Please pause the video. Please pause the video and try to do this question now. Okay, so basically try to do this question. So object is placed at 10 cm in front of a concave mirror which produces an erect image. So students, please note down, erect image is produced by the concave mirror only in one case that we have discussed in question number 12. So students note down that only one case of erect image is possible in case of concave mirror, that we have already discussed in question number 12. So that means this object is placed at 10 cm. So that means, okay, let's discuss this question on the black screen. Okay, so students, object is placed basically here. So let's suppose this distance is now 10 cm. This distance is basically, this is denoted by U. So U is basically, wait, color change. So this is basically the distance of object from the mirror. So this is pole here. So this is pole. So this is 10. So obviously its focal length will be more than 10. Because what we have to do, object will be placed between pole and focus. So that means this focal length will be greater than, it will be greater than 10. Its value will be greater than 10. And obviously radius of curvature will be more than 20. It can be 20.5. It can be 21. It can be 22. But it cannot be 20, because this focal length will be greater than 10. So focal length can be 10.1 also. 10.1. That means radius of curvature will be 20.2. So 20.2 can be radius. 10.05 can be the focal length. 10.05. So that means focal length will be more than 10. Focal length will be more than 10, and radius of curvature will be more than 20. It can be 20.00 something also, but it should be greater than 20. So right answer for this question will be, more than 20 centimeter. So radius of curvature in question number 13 we have to discuss, and the answer will be option number D, that is more than. So now the answer will be option number D. We have discussed the question up to the 13th question. So if you find this video useful, then you have to like this video, you have to share this video, and you have to subscribe the channel also. So all the things you have to do, then we will make the second part also. And drop the message that you are getting everything, any doubts you have. So question number 13, option number D will be the right answer. Next question. An object is placed at 20 centimeter in front of a concave mirror, which produces an erect image. So this is the another similar type of question. Erect image question. So erect image is formed in which case? Erect image is formed in that case when the object is placed between pole and focus. So now he is saying the radius of curvature of the mirror can be. So here it is an important question. Now you have to think the answer of question number 14. Try to do the answer of question number 14. What will be the answer? Pause the video and try the question, please. After that, we will obviously discuss the question and we will obviously discuss the answer also. Try to do the question, please. So now, he is saying an object is placed at 20 centimeter. So that means the focal length will be more than 20 centimeter. The focal length will be more than 20 centimeter. That's why the erect image can be formed by concave mirror, because there is only one case in which the concave mirror will produce erect image, and that case is the case in which object is placed between pole and focus. If we have discussed already, students, we have already discussed this question earlier also. So if I will go to this figure, then this will be the focus. This will be the focus and this will be radius of curvature. So here, students, the object will be placed between pole and focus. So this is pole. So that means its focal length will be, let's see what are the options now. So now he is saying radius of curvature of the mirror can be, okay, this is the distance of object from the mirror. So it is 20 centimeter, and 20 centimeter is obviously less than focus, because object is lying inside the focus and pole. So that means focal length will be greater than, firstly, focal length will be greater than 20. So for the first case, you can see here the radius of curvature is 30. अकॉर्डिंग टू 30 फोकल लेंथ विल बी 15 बट फोकल लेंथ शुड बी ग्रेटर देन 20 दैट इज द रिक्वायर्ड कंडीशन सो दैट मीन्स ऑप्शन नंबर ए इज एलिमिनेटेड. फॉर द सेकेंड क्वेश्चन यू कैन सी 40 सेंटीमीटर इज रेडियस ऑफ कर्वेचर दैट मीन्स फोकल लेंथ विल बी इक्वल टू 20 बट द ऑब्जेक्ट इज लाइंग इन साइड द फोकल लेंथ दैट इज इक्वल टू 20 ऑब्जेक्ट इज लाइंग इन साइड द फोकल लेंथ एंड द डिस्टेंस ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट फ्रॉम द मिरर इज 20 दैट मीन्स 20 इज नॉट द फोकल लेंथ इज मोर देन 20 सो फॉर द सेकेंड केस ऑल्सो फोकल लेंथ कैन नॉट बी इक्वल टू 20 ऑप्शन नंबर बी इज ऑल्सो एलिमिनेटेड. नाउ फॉर द थर्ड केस द फोकल लेंथ विल बी इक्वल टू 25 सेंटीमीटर सो दिस ऑप्शन कैन बी करेक्ट बिकॉज नाउ द ऑब्जेक्ट इज लाइंग इन साइड द फोकल लेंथ इज 25 एंड द ऑब्जेक्ट इज लाइंग एट 20 सेंटीमीटर फ्रॉम द मिरर सो 50 सेंटीमीटर कैन बी द आंसर इट कैन बी द रेडियस ऑफ कर्वेचर अकॉर्डिंग टू द गिवन कंडीशंस. फॉर क्वेश्चन नंबर 14 यूर आंसर राइट आंसर कैन बी ऑप्शन नंबर सी. प्लीज नोट डाउन दिस दीज आंसर्स ऑल्सो एंड इफ यू हैव नॉट गॉट दिस PDF देन यू कैन ड्रॉप यूर मैसेज टू मी. आई विल ट्राई दैट द लिंक फॉर दिस PDF कैन बी प्रोवाइडेड इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 14 वी हैव डन. नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 15. यस दिस इज द क्वेश्चन दैट यू हैव टू डू नाउ. क्वेश्चन नंबर 15 ट्राई दिस क्वेश्चन. This is the another question, similar type of question that are we have already discussed from the last 10 minutes. Question number 15, try this question. Which portion of the object will produce a magnified virtual image if a concave mirror of focal length 15 centimeter is being used? So students, this is another very important question. So similar type of questions you will definitely get in your examination. Similar type of questions you will get in term 1 examination. Well, CBSE will ask this type of questions. So now focal length of the concave mirror is given to you. Okay, if a concave mirror, okay, position you have to decide which position. So obviously, in case of concave mirror, when object is placed between pole and focus, in that case, if you will see this diagram, okay, wait students 1 minute. If you will see this diagram, then you can easily understand in which case we get the magnified image when the object is lying inside the when the object was lying here inside the pole and inside the focus and in between pole and focus. So that means if the focal length is 15 centimeter, then obviously position of object will be less than 15. This distance from the mirror should be less than 15. Basically, this is u, distance of object from the mirror. So this will be obviously less than 15. So concave mirror will produce only virtual image in only one case, that is when the object is placed between focal length and pole. So focal length is 15 centimeter. That means position of object should be less than 15. So u is position of object, u will be less than 15 centimeter. So option number B eliminated, C eliminated, option number A is possible. So which answer will be right? Option number A will be the right option for question number 15. Please note down the answers up to question number 15. The next questions we will discuss in the next part. So if you find this video useful, then please like this video, share this video and subscribe to our channel also, so that you will get all the regular updates. So this is all from today's session. Thank you so much to sir also who has motivated and guided me to do such work, and thank you to all the friends as well as family. So in the first part, this was the first part of first term syllabus of physics 10th class. So we have discussed 15 questions, and I request all the students to note down all these 15 questions. Approximately in all the classes, all the sections, these type of questions, these type of things we have already discussed. So thank you so much for watching this video. Take care. Bye bye. Have a nice day. Thank you so much.